put your arms around me like a circle around the sun. I want you to love me, baby, like my easy rider done. Don't believe
this is the old treadle wheel, and this is what most of us older potters around here grew up with. I don't know how early it was used around here. We know for certainty that it was used in the early 1800s. Then it continued to be the main turning source up until about 1950, I guess it was shortly after World War II. That's when the REA pulled the power in to the outlying areas, like to the pottery shops.
Dorothy Allman represents a typical Seagrove potter. Her work spans an entire evolution of making pots. She and the Allmans and the Teagues and the Cravens and the Owens have all learned to make pots from their fathers, who in turn learned to make pots from their fathers and their fathers, all the way back to Wedgwood, England. In 1969, Walter and Dorothy Allman opened the Seagrove Pottery Museum in an old railroad station. Here, among their extensive collection, you can best see the tradition of Seagrove pottery.
These are some pieces from our families. These are the Coles over here, and these are the Allman families, which both of them were over 100 years ago. Walter, what was your grandfather's name?
It was Fletcher Allman. And this is some of the examples that came from his kiln, which was made somewhere around 1880. And these pieces that I received came from my aunt, which was one of the oldest ones in the family.
That must have been Aunt Alice.
Yes, it was.
I remember her telling about helping put the wares in the kiln when she was just a little girl, like 5 and 6 years old.
This is an old groundhog kiln that was very difficult to use. You had to get out on your knees and crawl in and lay on your belly when you was loading it. The potters back then built their own kilns. They just dug the holes in the hillside and built the kilns in there for the earth used for support of holding the walls up. They fired the kilns with wood, and usually a hardwood, and then it was used for their last of the, what they call the blast, was used for lightwood or pine.
This groundhog kiln that was introduced at the early 1800s lasts continually on through till after World War II in some cases. These pieces were used by ladies in the kitchen. They would hold soda or salt or whatever that they needed, or in the case of the pie dish here, was for baking purposes. By the middle of the 1800s, salt glaze, of course, was being made, and the salt was made simply by throwing handfuls into a very hot kiln, and the salt would vaporize, and as the kiln cooled down, it would settle on the body of the clay, which would make a very hard finish. But also, there was an alkaline glaze being done. Then we also have the Albany slip type glaze coming in about 1870. The 1800s was a period of making stonewares, as these whiskey jugs show.
I hear the music now.
And during this time, the earthenware was still being made, and it was used for cooking, for it would stand the thermal shock much easier than the stoneware would. And it was transported by the wagoneers on the old plank road, which ran from Federal to Winston-Salem.
You can see by these jugs that they, the change of the shapes. Early 1800s, they were very bulbous. By 1840, they began to be less bulbous. By 1860, still less, and look how straight this one is, say about 18 and 80. They made it straight-sided so that it would, they would get more gallons in a kill, and also on the wagon. In the early 1900s, Prohibition began, and it ended the whiskey trade. Therefore, it ended the jug-making trade, too. A new customer came into being. These were people who had come into the Pinehurst area wanting new types of pottery. They did not have any need for milk crocks or churns or whiskey jugs. Instead, they wanted pretty vases, things that they had seen in their worldwide travels. Sometimes they would bring drawings with them, showing the potters just exactly what they wanted. So the potters began experimenting with new shapes and new glazes.
Jace Cole, or J.B. Cole Pottery, was one of the ones that did a lot of the experimenting with the earthenware and getting colors. All the potters were doing quite a bit at it, but Jace was one of the leading ones in working on the glazes and trying to get new things out for the public to look at and to buy. His family is still